Hi everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're gonna show you how to use EasyCafe software. So in the first video we did show you how to install, and we installed on a couple of computers so that you could see how everything works. So now what happens is you're gonna click on the software that was already installed. You say open. Okay, once you click open, it's gonna give you a chance to go to the software. So when you're on the software, the password, default password is EasyCafe. Okay, once you're in there, you click on demo. You say okay, if you bought it, it's fine anyway. So then when you're here, so you can see that is PC6, this is PC6. You can say, you can double click it, you give it time. That's the first thing to do. Another thing is like you can log it out, and you can see another PC came. Every PC which is connected is gonna come here. So what you do, you can give this guy time, PC2. I'm gonna give PC2. You say, you right click on the PC. If somebody's sitting there, you say special time prepaid. Then you say log, special login prepaid, login internet cafe, internet. You say okay. Then I'm gonna give this person 5 minutes. Okay, 5 minutes. I say okay. So when I go there, you're gonna see the it's opened, and since it's opened, it's gonna give you 5 minutes. You can see this 5 minutes. So once the 5 minutes is finished, this computer is gonna close automatically. So each and every client of yours, you can give them, maybe this one buys 5 minutes, this one 15 minutes, this one 10 minutes, this one 30 or hour, whatever. So if you want 1 hour, you do give, I'm gonna give this guy 1 hour, so which is gonna be a special login, then you say prepaid, then you say internet, then you can say 60, type in 60, then you say okay. When you type in 60, this is what you're gonna see. So after 60 minutes, it's gonna do that. So in case you forgot, instead of giving him 1 hour, instead of giving him 30 minutes, you give him 1 hour, you right click again, you say give time. So then you put a -30. So you put a negative number to decrease his time. And you put negative number, so you can see that now it's 30. So once it's 30, then you're fine. So then to log out, you click on it and log out. You say okay. Then you logged out to this computer. You're gonna see it's gonna log out, logged out. So you can also switch off that computer or reboot the computer, restart the computer. Maybe something happened. The client is just complaining that something's happening. The computer is not doing well. So you right click on that computer. Then you say, you can say system. When you go to system, then you can go and say login all PC. If I want to on all computers, I can give them time. If I click there, they're gonna all open once. So then if I say log out all PC, I can log out all PCs in case I'm going. Then log off user, you can select a user you want to log off. So shut down remote PC, you can shut down the selected PC or reboot that PC. I'm gonna reboot that PC. Look at this. I'm gonna select that PC and say reboot. I want you to see. Okay, if I click, it's gonna say yes here. Say yes, then you can see it's gonna reboot. It's restarting the computer. After when it's restarting, then it's gonna be, everything's gonna be fine. It's gonna go off and come on. So in the meantime, once we're waiting for that, I'm gonna show you something else. You click on accounts. You saw I clicked on accounts. Accounts, I want to give somebody a new account. Maybe somebody else came and he wants a username and password. Instead of giving them time, you can create accounts. Then you give them a username and password. They can sit anywhere. Then you don't give a computer. You know, sometimes you can find a client wants to sit in a corner or wants to, you know, all those things. So what you do, you click on accounts and go to plus. Once you click on plus, you type in the username they want to use. Maybe we want to use Azania. Azania. Okay, then our password, we can, whatever you want to do, we can give. If you want to know this is a customer, you can say to other things you cannot do, you might do them or you might not do them. So, but I'm gonna just do them so that I can remember this person. Okay, I'm gonna give this guy Azania, the name and the also the password gonna be Azania. Okay, that's the name and the password is what? Azania. I paste the password there. If I want the surname, I can put the surname, TT, and also you can leave everything like this if you want, but if you want to put address, maybe 15 Rose Road, Houghton Estate. Okay, if you want to script this person, if you, it's up to you. Houghton. If you don't want to put all of this, you can leave them the way you want them to live. Okay, and we say London. Okay, after that you can put a zip code, you can put a cell phone number if you want to, but I don't want to do all of that. So you can see Azania is already there. After that you say apply. Once I've applied, so this guy, now we go to connections and we go to accounts. So when we go to accounts, you can see that we have what they call Azania is there, is the only account I have, PC1, PC2. So what I do, I can click on Azania. If I'm there on Azania, whenever he comes, I can click on that account. Then I say give time. If I say give time, I can give Azania maybe 15 minutes. He paid his money. Then I save. Once I save, so I don't have to tell Azania where to log in or where not to log in. Why? Because he has a username and password. He can sit on any computer. So what's going to happen here? He's going to go, like Azania comes in here and he clicks on this and say Azania. Azania. And then after that, and say to Azania password. Azania. Okay, then you say enter. If he says enter, you can see he logs in without no stress. So that's the way you create also accounts. You can create your clients some accounts so that they can be independent. I wanna sit here, I'm Azania. So, but also I can log out without telling you the person. Maybe I discovered this computer is slow. Then I can sit on this computer using the same username and password. As long as I go and I switch off here, you get me? It will be easier, you get me? So if I'm done with that account, you can create another account. You can create as many accounts as you want, but on a trial version, you might not create as many as you can. So now, what you're gonna happen here, Azania Tutorials was in, so now we, let's see. Let me go log in, there's something I wanna show you. Tina. No. Soft. Easy Cafe. No, I don't want that. I want to log in as Azania. Okay, let me log in. Okay, I didn't put in the right password, so let me put in again Azania. Azania. Let me put in Azania. Okay, Azania is logged in now. Let him use some means. Then after when he has done finishing doing that, then we're gonna see that his time is gonna be decreasing on the computer there. So we go here and we wait. Okay, once his time is finished, he'll never log in. It will be telling him you don't have time. You can see on this PC, you can see it shows us that Azania is sitting on PC. Even if it changes the PC, it's gonna show us that Azania is sitting on another PC, on another PC, on another PC. Okay, guys, this PC came back. This one came back. And then what we want to do? Tina Soft. Something I wanna do. I wanna put in the password here. There was deep freeze on this computer, so that's why we can't see it took out every password. 168.8.102. Look at this. When the computer is not connected, it's gonna show in red. You get me? It simply means you switched it off. You get me? But once I switch or I close this software, and I put it back, it won't show that computer because it's not connected, but it was connected, so it's red. It was connected, switched off, and something happened which the software doesn't understand. So once you manage to save that, you will see that the computer is gonna come to life. 192.168.8.102. So that's the password we have. So after having that, we're gonna log out here, and we see this one. Okay, so you see now it's blue. Wow. Once it's blue, you're gonna see it's connected. So now Azania guy is having only 13 minutes here. You can see once his time finishes, he's gonna have to pay us more money to use the computer. See, he's remaining with 5. So what happens with Azania if he wants to log in 2 computers? Maybe he gives his friend a username and password. What's gonna happen? And also he wants to use the computer. Azania. Okay, I'm trying to log in. You're gonna see what the Azania. You're gonna see what the software is gonna tell us. You see, please wait. User is currently online. You can see he cannot log in to 2 computers at the same time. See, that's a good thing about it. So now we're gonna go and we log out on this first computer here. Once you log out, then you're gonna have a chance to do what, to log into the second computer. Okay, that's fine. So now what you're gonna do here, I can go to the second computer now. You can see Azania logged out, so now he's gonna try to log in here. Azania. Okay, you can see now he managed to log in because he logged out that side. So if you don't log out on the second computer, you won't have a chance to do that. So now here, he has 12 minutes only, and also on the computer you can see that Azania changed the computer. He's sitting on computer what? On computer 12. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, and that's the way you use your EasyCafe. We might do another tutorial to show you a couple of things, because the first one we installed, now the second one will show you how to use. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.